Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to study about introduction to HTML. Let's move ahead. HTML. So what is HTML? HTML is none but hypertext markup language. HTML is a document that contains text. Various web browsers can read and display document that contain HTML. Uses various web components like web pages, website, web browser, web server, URL, HTTP and HTML. So friends, HTML is none but the code that contains text, and we need to execute that text code with the help of various web browser. Let's move ahead and check. HTML code is written under the angular bracket. So angular bracket are the one to specify the code for of programming for web pages. So what is the structure of HTML? So the structure of HTML is, we need to start, that is, you must be knowing into the programming language, we use it as a header part. So we need to start with the header part as first tag HTML. HTML, it is the opening tag. You can check over here. It is written into the angular bracket and it is called as opening tag. Simultaneously, you can have the reference of this. Here you can check forward slash, which indicates the closing tag of HTML. Similarly, if you move inside to the HTML tag to specify the head of your web page, we use head tag, and it is opening head tag, and this tag with forward slash is the close head tag. So inside this head tag portion, we can specify the head part of your web page. Moving ahead, when you need to specify the body of your web page, you use body tag. Again, it is the opening body tag tag, and simultaneously when you would like to end this, so forward slash and body tag, it indicates that your code ends over here under the body part. So inside the HTML, there are two important parts. That is, the first one, head part, and another one is the body part. Head part is used to display the title, the name, the head you would like to give to your web page, and inside the web page, what contents you want can be mentioned over here inside the body tag. So let's move ahead and check what are the categories of HTML tags. So there are two different categories of HTML tag. If you would like to check for the first tag, container tag, and second one is empty tag. Just now we have checked container tag. The container tags are called as paired tags, and it is also called as beginning and end tag. Just now we have checked the example like HTML tag. It is the head tag, opening tag, and simultaneously with the forward slash, it is the end tag. So it can be identified as a beginning tag, and it can be identified as end tag. So it is in the form of pair. You can check over here HTML. Similarly, HTML, it is also present over here, but it is the opening tag and it is the close tag, beginning and end tag. So the tag which contains some code which have beginning tag, which have end tag, are called as container tags. Whereas what are empty tags? As per its name, empty, nothing. It means standalone tags, standalone, which are not dependent on the paired one. So that is why it is called as standalone tags. It do not have end tag. It means likewise, you can check over here that it is the beginning tag and it is end tag. But for empty tag, as they are standalone tag, they do not have end tag. For example, Here now we can check the example of br tag. It is to specify the breaking line. So break tag, br tag is called as empty tag. Whereas there are different tags which are having the pair tags. There are different tags which can be begin and end with a pair are called as container tag. So these are the two categories of HTML tag. So let's move ahead. Which platform you will be using for the programming? So for HTML programming, you will be using text editor as Notepad, Microsoft Notepad, or else you know very well that if we are going to use FOSS as application, so Libre text editor also you can use into LibreOffice pack. So Libre text editor or Notepad as a text editor, you can use any text editor to perform the programming of HTML tags. Let's move ahead. When you need to run the code for HTML, at that time the text editor file which you will be using to write down the code, it will be having the extension as .txt, and when you save it, you need to save it as .html, the same file with the extension .html. So whatever the default web browser will be there for your system, it will get converted into the HTML file of that web browser. It means the text editor file can create web page of your default web browser. What you need to do for that? You need to save the text editor file with the extension of .html. So friends, this was all about the introduction of HTML. I hope you must have received some of the knowledge about the HTML. In the further videos, we will be moving ahead about the differentiation between HTML and HTML5 and how to create, how to start with the coding, how to create your first web page. Thank you so much for watching my video. I hope you have subscribed this channel. If you have not yet subscribed the channel, you can subscribe my channel for the updated videos. Thank you so much for watching.